1939, when World War II broke out, Stalin considered Finland, the Baltics, and Poland as the most likely to be responsible for the next imperialist act on the USSR. Two were taken care of by the Non-Aggression Pact. But one country remained, Finland. Finland was friendly with the countries in Western Europe, and Stalin knew he had to take it before someone else did. The Soviet Union sought to obtain Finnish territory, but Finland refused. Not taking no for an answer, on November 30th, 1939, after the outbreak of World War II, the Soviet Union invaded Finland. The Soviet Union had a large army of about 750,000 soldiers in all, while Finland only had about 300,000 soldiers. However, while the Soviet Union may have had a large number of soldiers, Finland had better trained soldiers. One of the best trained branches was the Finnish snipers, most notably Simo Haeha. Simo was a farmer in a town that soon became very close to the Russian border. In 1925, Haeha served a mandatory one-year service in Finland's army. This was the only military training he ever got before he was called back 13 years later in 1939. From November 1939 to March of 1940, Simo allegedly sniped down a staggering 505 enemy soldiers, which makes him the single deadliest sniper in history, ever. Some sources claim Simo shot down up to 540 soldiers, but none declare any less than 500. This does not include the numbers he had on the front lines, because he also racked up several hundred more with a submachine gun, which is estimated to bring his total up to around 800. The invading Soviet army began to fear this master sniper and nicknamed him White Death. As the name suggests, the Winter War lasted for a single winter. This means Simo only worked his magic for under 100 days. And in the winter, there aren't many hours of sunlight. This means he was gunning down an average of 5 enemy soldiers a day. Then, when he went to join the Finnish Civil Guard, he climbed to the second lieutenant, the largest leap in rank in Finnish history. Simo used a few interesting tactics to gain an advantage on his opponents. He did not use a scope, but only an iron sight on his M2830 rifle. He did so for 4 reasons. The first was because he hadn't been trained with the telescopic rifles. Secondly, the telescopic sights could fog up with frost in the cold temperatures, which peaked at around negative 4 degrees and got as low as negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit. He would have to raise his head slightly to see through the telescopic sight. These would give enemies a larger and easier target, even though he was only 5'3". Lastly, he knew that the sun could reflect off the glass, giving away his position. Another tactic he used to hide his position was using the snow around him as to his advantage. He packed a mound of snow in front of him because he preferred to sit as he shot. He also put snow around his gun to prevent visible smoke from the gunpowder. Most intelligently, he put snow in his mouth so that his breath wouldn't show, which would let enemy snipers know where he was. Simo was such a threat that the Soviets sent counter-snipers to combat him specifically, but every time he would take care of the enemy snipers before they even had a chance. Because they could not capture him or shoot him from far, the Soviet army would launch artillery strikes on his approximate location. But Simo escaped every time with nothing but a rip in his camouflage. The camouflage was another important advantage Simo and his fellow Finns had on the Soviet troops. The Finnish army wore white covers to blend into the snow. Because of Stalin's purges of the army, they wore only bright green uniforms, which made them stand out against the snowy white lands. The Finnish also had skis, and they were able to move very quickly across the snow, an efficient luxury that the majority of the Soviets lost in the purges. There were very few roads on the border of Finland, and those that existed were guarded heavily by Finnish troops. Another problem the purges created was that the Soviets lacked any officers with leadership skills because Stalin had them all executed when he purged the USSR of any potential political opponents. Even though the Soviet invasion of Finland was technically successful, they only managed to capture a relatively small amount of border territory, leaving the rest of the country untouched. Surprisingly, the Soviets suffered nearly 400,000 casualties, including over 1,000 tanks and almost 500 aircraft. This was incredibly high compared to just 70,000 suffered by Finland. On March 6, 1948, one of the Red Army snipers was able to hit Seimo with an expanding bullet, which was illegal at the time, showing that Seimo was so much better at playing the game that the only way to beat him was to break the rules. He was knocked unconscious and fell into a coma. Amazingly, Seimo regained consciousness on March 18th, the same day that the Moscow Peace Treaty was signed. This marked the end of the 105-day Winter War. Finland had to cede border areas to the Soviet Union, but the fighting stopped. I guess the big, tough USSR wasn't prepared for Seimo, round two. Seimo had survived World War II, and he went back to hunting and farming. The Finnish government actually gave him a farm in 1961 to reward him for his service. Seimo lived on to become a dog breeder and a moose hunter. He even hunted with the Finnish president, Urho Kekkonen. He moved into a small apartment where he lived the rest of his days before passing away at age 96 in 2002. That's right, born in 1905, the deadliest sniper of World War II and possibly history lived to age 96 and died of natural causes just 17 years ago. At age 92 in 1998, he was asked how he was able to do what he did. He answered, "I only did my duty and what I was told to do as well as I could."